this lecture, you will learn more about the figures, the causes of marine litter, its effects on animals and humans, and recent strategies and remedies to face this harmful environmental problem. You will also have many hints about the consequences of human bad habits in using and managing plastic objects. Are you ready to take action starting from your everyday life? Marine litter is human-created waste, any persistent solid material that is manufactured or processed directly or indirectly, intentionally or unintentionally, abandoned into or arrived into the coastal or marine environment. In recent years, it has become an increasing environmental problem, and now there is greater concern compared to a few years ago. Reduction of marine pollution is target one of the Sustainable Development Goal number 14, Life Below Water. Most waste that can be found in the sea or on the beaches has an anthropogenic origin, comes from the land and the rivers, and an important share of it is plastic. Do you know which are the two main negative effects of marine litter? They are related to the presence of the waste itself in the seas and on the beaches, and the long decomposition time of the plastic waste. Both create conditions for micro pieces of plastic which animals may mistake for food, and for growing accumulation of harmful plastic litter in oceans and seas. Data about quantity and typologies of debris depend on the surveyed items. Marine litter surveys can involve waste on the beaches, floating waste, submerged waste, or collected waste during fishing activities. Recent data on the presence of floating marine litter in the Mediterranean Sea close to the Italian coast reported that 88% of the monitored marine debris is of anthropogenic origin, and 95.7% of it is plastic. About 50% consists in plastic debris, which is non-attributable to identifiable objects. While among the identifiable plastic objects, the first three are bags, sheets, nets, and fishing lines. Other figures about waste collected during fishing-related activities by the Italian National Research Council Institute of Marine Science of Ancona reported different figures, for example, 43% of plastic and 24% of metal. What are the main causes and sources of marine litter? 80% of the plastic found in the oceans is estimated to have come from land-based sources. The remaining 20% is thought to be the result of water-related activities. Frequent and land-diffused bad habits contribute to this problem, such as cigarette hands in the drains, ignoring plastic waste on the ground, especially when close to rivers, excessive usage of single-use plastic objects, and illegal dumping. The virtuous contribution by each of us can create the basis to reduce this problem with success. By reducing the usage of single-use plastic objects, avoiding cosmetic products such as scrubs and toothpaste with microbeads, collecting waste on the ground whenever possible, collecting cigarette hands on the beaches, and not abandoning waste. What are the effects and impacts of the presence of plastic in the oceans? Microplastics. Small pieces of plastic under 5 millimeters, due to their size and color, confuse animals and cause malnutrition and risk for their health and existence. Studies have shown that about 700 species have encountered marine debris, and 92% of these interactions are with plastic. A study by Rochman that sampled fish species from markets in Makassar, Indonesia, and California, USA, found anthropogenic debris respectively in 55% and 67% of all species. A curious and effective research method conducted by marine biologists in the Italian National Research Council Institute of Marina di Torre Grande in Sardinia, where turtles are temporarily hospitalized in case of necessity, shows that the researcher can extract the inorganic waste from turtle excrement and catalog it. The results: on average, every turtle needs 14 days to clean its intestine from the marine litter, with a peak of 30 days for the bounty packaging. Since 84% of the plastic was found to have at least one persistent bioaccumulative toxic chemical, animals consuming this debris are therefore ingesting the chemicals attached to the plastic. Once plastic enters the marine food chain, there is a possibility that it will contaminate the human food chain as well. Through a process called bioaccumulation, chemicals in plastic will enter the body of the animal feeding on the plastic, and as the feeder becomes prey, the chemicals will pass to the predator, making their way up to the food chain that includes humans. Other important categories of microplastics can also originate from the erosion of tires when driving, the paint used to lay out roads markings, and the abrasion of synthetic textile during washing. Are there any remedies or strategies to reduce this problem? Waste prevention, waste collection, stopping plastic from reaching the ocean, and educating people to reduce the use of single-use plastic containers and bottles are the most important strategies to reduce the marine litter problem. Based on existing rules, such as those of the Marine Strategy Framework Directive and on the Port Reception Facilities Directive, the European Union is now turning its attention to the 10 most frequent single-use plastic products and fishing gear found in marine litter in Europe, aiming at preventing new waste in the sea. For fishing gear, nets, lines, pots, traps, which accounts for 27% of all beach litter, the European Commission will encourage all actors involved to get the maximum of derelict gear back to shore and include it in the waste and recycling streams. Producers of plastic fishing gear will be required to cover the cost of waste collection from port reception facility and its transport and treatment. They will also cover the cost of awareness-raising measures. The contribution of fishermen is important too. They can collect the marine waste during their fishing activity and take it back to shore with a program called Fishing for Litter. Finally, some concluding remarks give us new hope for the future. Internationally, it is important to say that many developing countries have put a total ban on plastic bags. In 2002, Bangladesh became the first country in the world to ban plastic bags after they were found to have blocked the drainage system during devastating floods. Other countries, including South Africa, Rwanda, China, Australia, Italy, and several others, followed suit. The use of new tools aiming to clean the seas from plastic waste and, more importantly, rivers to achieve waste-free waters before entering into the seas is under testing, and some prototypes give hope for the future. Everybody can contribute individually, you too. For example, reducing the consumption of single-use plastic objects such as plastic bottles, collecting waste when you see them, and participating to group cleaning activities on beaches or along the rivers.